The aim of this video is to show you a quick and dirty way to reliably sharpen a drill bit on a bench grinder. Unit of competency, E102, requires you to sharpen two drill bits. Before we make sparks, we need to understand the drill bit's cutting edges and angles so that we know what we're trying to achieve on the grinder. The two cutting edges of a drill, this part and this part, do 90%, 99% of the work of a drill. They need to be identical in three dimensions to cut a clean hole and to cut well. The first way in which the two cutting edges need to be identical is in their position along the length or the axis of the drill bit, like so. The geometric centre of the bit falls in the middle of this chisel that connects the two flutes and the two ground planes. If these two cutting edges are at different positions along the length or axis of the bit, then this chisel, instead of being straight across at 90 degrees to the length of the bit, will be offset at an angle one way or the other. This will move the longest part of the drill to the left or the right of centre. In doing so, it'll be the first, the main part of the drill to touch the job will be to left or right of centre, and it'll cause the drill to oscillate in the job. The two cutting edges must be ground to the same angle. If one is ground flatter than the other is ground steeper, then the edge that's ground flat will be in contact with the job, and the edge that's being ground steeper will not contact the job at all. This will force the drill to one side, causing it to oscillate in the hole. Lastly, the two cutting edges must have the same cutting angle. It's sometimes called relief angle because this back part here is sloping back away from the cutting edge. If this cutting angle is too sharp, then the cutting edge will be delicate. It'll blunt quickly, it'll overheat, it'll chip, it'll crack. If it isn't sharp enough, like so, then the drill won't cut cleanly. It'll scrape its way around, scraping up iron filings instead of shavings. It'll heat up and you'll need a lot of extra pressure to drill the hole more slowly. If we reverse this relief angle completely, the drill won't cut at all. The back of the grind will be longer than the cutting edge and it'll skate around on the back. If the drill is merely blunt, a couple of quick passes on each side with the grinder will restore the edge without upsetting the symmetry, so long as you do the same to both sides. Your first tool is your Mark 1 eyeball. If you can see a difference between the two cutting edges, rotating it from side to side like so, if you can see a difference, then they are different. Once you start getting very close to the same though, you need something a bit more accurate than Mark 1 eyeball. Here's a drill bit with significant issues. No gauge needed to see that this one has been ground the wrong way on the cutting edge here and rounded off over the back. It's got a point instead of a chisel at the top, and the two cutting edges are significantly different angles and length. We know how to measure it now, but how are we going to actually achieve identical cutting edges at complex angles on a complex spiral object with large parts missing? We're going to do this by thinking backwards. We're not going to grind cutting edges. We're going to grind material away from behind where we want the cutting edges to be, leaving a cutting edge.